Hello, welcome to celldiffusion.com. In this video, we will learn about a generalized plant and animal cells. The generalized cell is the basic representation of animal or plant cell, which shows all parts and organelles which can be present in a specialized cell. Animal and plant body is made up of innumerous types of cells, which vary greatly in shape and structure. The structure of a cell is often related to the function it performs. For example, red blood cell in human has the shape of the biconcave disc. This helps it to pass through narrow capillaries and transport oxygen. On the other hand, a nerve cell is of an irregular shape with a long thread-like structure. This helps it to conduct impulse from distant parts of the body to the brain. The muscle cell is long and possesses elasticity. This feature helps it to contract and relax to pull or squeeze the parts. Although all of the cells are different in shape and perform different functions, yet all of them show some basic structural plan. This basic representation of cells showing all features is called a generalized cell. The generalized cells differs for plant and animal due to the presence and absence of certain parts or organelles. Vacuoles in plant cells are much larger in size as comparison to animal cells. Animal cells contain centrosome, whereas plant cells do not. Plant cells contain plastids, whereas animal cells lack the same. All plant and animal cells consist of living and non-living parts. The living part of the cell includes the cell membrane, the cytoplasm and the nucleus. All three together are known as protoplasm. The non-living parts of the cell are granules and vacuoles. Let us now discuss the different parts of the generalized cell of animal and plant in detail. Cell is surrounded by a very thin and flexible skin covering called cell membrane or plasma membrane. It is the outermost layer in animal cells and the second outermost layer in plant cells. Cell membrane is a living membrane made up of lipoprotein. The main function of cell membrane is to protect the cell and provides shape to it. There are very tiny holes in the cell or plasma membrane. It allows materials to enter and leave the cell through these tiny pores or openings. However, its permeability is selective. It means it allows certain substances to pass through it and prevents others. It has been seen that people often get confused between cell membrane and cell wall. Please note, cell wall is only present in plant cell. It is an extra covering that surrounds the cell membrane of a plant cell. It is made up of stiff non-living material called cellulose. The cell wall provides rigidity and protection to the cell. Unlike the cell membrane, it is freely permeable and allows all substances in solution form to pass through it. Animal cells do not have a cell wall. Next, cytoplasm. The cytoplasm is a jelly-like semi-liquid structure occupying most of the inside of the cell. It occupies the space between the cell membrane and the nucleus. Under a microscope, it appears to be colorless, partly transparent, and somewhat watery. It is a living part of the cell, and all the living functions take place in the cytoplasm. All metabolic activities occur in it. The living cytoplasm is always in a state of motion. The cytoplasm is embedded with tiny parts or structures called the organelles. Organelle means the little organs. Organelles have definite structure and definite functions in the cell and have the same status in the cell as the organs have in the body of an animal or a plant. Let's learn about these organelles in brief. This irregular network of double membrane tube-like structure is called endoplasmic reticulum. It is of two types, smooth and rough. The endoplasmic reticulum appears rough due to the presence of particles like ribosomes attached to its surface. Its main function is to provide the supporting framework of the cell. The ribosomes are numerous small granules, either scattered freely in the cytoplasm or attached to the membranes of the endoplasmic reticulum. The function of the ribosome is protein synthesis. Mitochondria are the sites where cellular respiration occurs to release energy. Therefore, we can call mitochondria as powerhouse of the cell or seat of cellular respiration. These tiny vesicles of different shapes arranged in parallel stacks located near the nucleus are called Golgi apparatus. They act as the delivery system of the cell. Lysosomes are small vesicles of different shapes that budded off from Golgi bodies. They contain 40 different types of powerful digestive enzymes. They use these enzymes to clean cell by digesting any foreign material as well as worn out cell organelles. During the disturbance in cellular metabolism, for example, when the cell gets old or damaged, lysosomes may burst and enzymes released digest their cell. Hence, these are called suicide bags. A centrosome is present in animal cells only. Centrosomes consist of two barrel-shaped clusters of microfilaments placed at right angle to each other are called centroles. They initiate and regulate cell division. Plastids are present only in plant cells. The function of plastids in the cell is to manufacture and store food in plants. Last, not the least, comes the nucleus. The nucleus is a spherical body present inside the cell. This structure is a control center of the cell, and its function is to regulate and coordinate the various life processes of the cell. Most cells have only one nucleus, but some cells, like that of muscles, have more than one nucleus. The nucleus comprises of four parts: nuclear membrane, nuclear sap or nucleoplasm, nucleolus, and chromatin fibers. Nuclear membrane is the delicate outermost covering of the nucleus. It separates the nucleus from the cytoplasm. Nuclear membrane, like the cell membrane, has tiny holes in it which allow the exchange of substances between the nucleus and the cytoplasm. Nucleoplasm is the jelly-like fluid inside the nucleus. Chromatin fibers and nucleoli are embedded in the nucleoplasm. A network of thread-like structures called the chromatin network is present in the nucleoplasm. It consists of DNA and proteins. At the time of cell division, the chromatin fibers develop into thick ribbon-like or rod-like structures called chromosomes. These chromosomes play an important role in carrying the genetic characters from the parents to the offspring. Nucleolus is a dense, dark, granular structure without a membrane. It consists of RNA, ribonucleic acid, and proteins. It is the site of ribosome formation, thus we can call it the factory of ribosomes. The non-living parts of the cell are granules and vacuoles. Granules are small particles in the cytoplasm which stores food particles such as starch, glycogen, and fats. Vacuoles are clear spaces in the cytoplasm. They are filled with water and various substances in the solution state. A single membrane called tenoplast bound these bubble-like sacs. In the plant cells, the vacuoles are usually quite large and the liquid which they contain is called cell sap. The cell sap contains proteins, minerals, organic acids, etc. Vacuoles provide turgidity and rigidity to the cell. An animal cell does not have such prominent vacuoles, and vacuoles are fewer in number. I hope you like the video. Thank you for watching. Please do subscribe Cell Tuition for more such videos.